The dawn of a new era and finally the time for major reform in world football. That's how Australian soccer has greeted the news that the man who ruled FIFA with an iron grip for 17 years, Sepp Blatter, has resigned. The shock announcement came just days after Blatter was re-elected as FIFA president. Blatter says he stepped down because he no longer has the support of fans and players. But there have also been media reports that the most powerful man in world sport is under FBI investigation. Philip Williams begins our coverage.
This was a man who fought to the career death to hang on to the FIFA presidency just last Friday, and won despite the threats of splits and boycotts.
Let's go, FIFA! Let's go, FIFA!
But it was not FIFA going, but its controversial captain.
Le soutien de l'intégralité.
I do not feel that I have a mandate from the entire world of football. The fans, the players, the clubs, the people who live, breathe and love football as much as we all do at FIFA.
Autant que nous tous à la FIFA.
What changed in the past few days? Certainly the pressure over multi-million dollar payments connected to South Africa's successful 2010 World Cup bid has intensified. It's also clear last week's arrests of FIFA officials were not the end of investigations by US or Swiss authorities. The news for FIFA was almost certainly going to get worse.
Well, you have to ask yourself, why did the executive of FIFA decide to put a World Cup, which is supposed to be in August, in Qatar, which is vastly too hot, against the advice of their own safety committee? And the answer is, you know, I'll leave it to you to make your own conclusion. I think if I was the Qatari team that won, I'd be very worried.
English football chief Greg Dyke says the awarding of the 2022 World Cup to Qatar, a bid Australia lost, must now be thoroughly investigated. The man who denied, who defied and never stepped back has finally declared it's over. What or not are the investigations into the secretive world he commanded for so long? Philip Williams, ABC News.
The head of Football Federation Australia, Frank Lowy, says he's been working behind the scenes for years to bring about change at FIFA. Mr. Lowy said he's been nursing a bitter grievance ever since Australia lost its bid for the 2022 World Cup to Qatar. He says Australia ran a clean bid, but admits the FFA was duped when it handed over $500,000 in the name of football development in the Caribbean.
They're the winners.
Consensus isn't common in Australian soccer, but Sepp Blatter's demise has delivered exactly that.
I think today is a better day than it was yesterday.
It was necessary. It should have happened earlier, that's true. Nevertheless, it's not enough.
Australian football's boss Frank Lowy calls his resignation the dawn of a new era, which should open the door to major reform. His opposition to Blatter's recent re-election now appears vindicated.
All those who voted against Blatter would have paid a price. And essentially, it was the Americans, it was us, it was the European nations.
With Blatter going, the decision to award the 2022 World Cup to Qatar loses its biggest defender. And as corruption investigators delve further into the bidding process, calls to start it from scratch are growing, especially in Australia, which spent $45 million on its own failed bid.
In fact, I think that the Qatar 2022 will be investigated and very likely will be set aside.
In an open letter, Frank Lowy concedes Australia's bid was flawed. Did we make mistakes? He writes, yes. Would we do things differently in future? Absolutely. One of those mistakes was paying $500,000 for football development in the Caribbean, money which ended up in the pocket of Jack Warner, one of the FIFA executives arrested last week. Frank Lowy insists he was duped. We ran a clean bid and we are proud of that, but it wasn't a level playing field and therefore we didn't win it.
This whole bid process for the 2022 World Cup is completely dodgy and suspect. Australia deserves its money back.
The Socceroos, champions of Asia.
The game might be beautiful, but this chapter is anything but. Ben Worsley, ABC News.
And in some breaking news, Interpol says it's put six men with ties to FIFA on its most wanted list. A so-called red notice has also been issued for former Vice President Jack Warner, the official implicated in the $500,000 grant by Australia to a Caribbean football academy.